Hello, everybody. It's that college football guy here in another video. Oh, boy. It was a fun night last night. I recorded the video yesterday. Started my trip down to Georgia. It's actually end up where I'm at now, Wilmington, North Carolina. But I got down to Adairsville, spent the night there, and they said there's a thunderstorm coming through. Okay, so I kind of parked myself in one spot. It's kind of a unique place, but I'm like, oh, this may be okay if the storm comes through the way I think it is. I was right. Only problem is I wake up like this. Truck's rocking. It's about midnight. I'm like, what in the world's going on? So I gotta look, and I see rain this way just flying by. And I'll try to look that way, and I can't even see anything. I'm not about to open the window or go out and look. I mean, it's come by hard, and the truck is just bouncing. I'm like, what in the world? Look at the radar in the middle of a... The radar was red and brown and flashing where I was, which is not good. No tornadoes. There were tornadoes back in Tennessee. But, nor tornadoes where I was at. But the wind on there, because literally the storm was coming in where the back end of the trailer, the doors of the trailer, was what the wind was hitting. And it was hitting it so hard, it was trying to lift the trailer up or shift it side to side, and that's what was moving the whole truck. So because of that, I got woken up. It took me about another hour to get to sleep when the storm finally passed. And I stopped feeling like I was being hit. Because I've been in a truck that somebody backed into and hit. And you're rocked all over the place. Like, what in the world? But no, it was just a storm. It passed through. Here comes the fun part. I get up in the morning, drive through Atlanta, avoid a few trees on the interstate. Not as many people driving through. Storm damage, some power was out, about 7:30 in the morning. Those who drive through Atlanta in a truck know 7:30 in the morning, it's normally backed up a good half an hour. I had pretty much smooth sailing, which is weird. But I saw a lot of places with no lights. Power was out, less people working. Maybe wait until the power comes on later or whatever. But I get in and get in here, and I got in a pretty good clip, and the storm was not moving that fast, they told me. And now I look at the storm track, and there's two different storm cells coming through. I don't know if this is the same one I had, but it's going to hit here tonight with almost the same type of red and flashing brown right where I'm at in Wilmington, North Carolina. Supposedly. It doesn't shift track. I get to enjoy this not once, but twice. Ah, boy. So, hopefully it's not too crazy. But enough about that. Let's get into the scheduled preview we're talking about, and that's the Arkansas Razorbacks, who had a really up and down year. They just never really could, I look at their schedule last season, never really could get things on track. It just never really developed. They had an incredible bowl game, I'll give them that, which put them in the winning record for the season at 7-6. They were 6-6 going into the bowl game. But we're going to see about that, and we're going to see, let me know in the comments if you think they have a chance of a better record than last season. So we're going to do with these scheduled previews. Not predictions, they're previews. We'll go through the non-conference games from last season and this season, decide which one's tougher, and the conference schedule. Oh, not the conference schedule. The entire schedule from last season and this season. And decide which one's tougher. Okay. Here we go. Non-conference games from last season. And it's going to be kind of funny. Because an opponent didn't change, but it did. I'll get into that. Non-conference games from last season. Home against Cincinnati. Home against Missouri State. At BYU. Home against Liberty. 3 group of 5. 1 FCS. 1 group of 5 BYU on the road. This season's non-conference games. Neutral site Western Carolina in Little Rock, home against Kent State, home against BYU, home against FIU. Since BYU is now in the Big 12, one Power 5, two Group of 5, one FCS. A home and home, you go from a Group of 5 to a, you have a Group of 5 team on the road and now a Power 5 team at home. But you plan to, it's all just a home and home. It's just the way things changed. And since BYU is technically, is now officially a Power 5, I have to say the non-conference games are tougher this season than last season. Weird saying it. Now, as for the full schedule, we'll go through last season's schedule and we'll see what we got here. They started the season off at home, against Cincinnati and won 31-24. Then home against South Carolina, 144-30. Home against Missouri State, they won 38-27. Then there's the annual game they play against Texas A&M, which is always in Arlington. Jerry World, AT&T Stadium, Jerry World. I believe. I could be wrong. Let me know in the comments. They lost 23-21 to Texas A&M. Then they go home against Alabama, lost 49-26. So start with five straight home games. Now you're at Mississippi State, you lose 40-17. You're at BYU, you win 52-35. That's actually impressive. Then you get a bye week. So you had seven in front of the bye and five after. Excuse me. Then you're at Auburn, you win 41-27. Home against Liberty, you lose 21-19 to a Group of Five school. Home against LSU, you lose 13-10. Home against Ole Miss, you win 42-27. At Missouri, you lose 29-27. You put a 6-6. And then they had one of the better Liberty Bowls in the past few years. They beat Kansas. Really, dude? You're going to park in my mirror and chirp, huh? He's literally in my front side mirror chirping if you hear him. Take off, dude. Thank you. Against Kansas. In Liberty Bowl, they beat Kansas 55-53 in three overtimes. It was a game. Now their schedule this season. Home against Western Carolina, neutral site in Little Rock. Home against Kent State. Home against BYU. Start conference playoff at LSU. Neutral site against Texas A&M and Arlington. At Ole Miss. At Alabama. Home against Mississippi State. Then they get the bye. They're at Florida, home against Auburn, home against Florida International, FIU, and finish the season at home against Missouri. Now, which season was tougher? Well, let's look, the way I measured this is simple. The road games. Your road games from last season were at Mississippi State, at BYU, at Auburn, at Missouri. Is that right? Mississippi State at by well, that's right, four road games. And you go 7-6. This season, at LSU, at Ole Miss, at Alabama, at Florida. You have two neutral sites, but that's the same thing here. I have to say this season is tougher because at LSU, at Alabama, at Ole Miss. Any two of those are probably, you got all three of them in one season, and you have nothing compared to that compared to last year. Yeah, this season's schedule is tougher. So I have to say that. You're going to let me know your thoughts down in the comments. So thanks, everybody, for watching the video. Let me know in the comments. One, they finished 7-6 last year with the current schedule of home against the neutral site, Western Carolina against, in Little Rock, home against Kent State, home against BYU, at LSU. Neutral site against Texas A&M and Arlington, at Ole Miss, at Alabama, home against Mississippi State, at Florida, home against Auburn, home against FIU, home against Missouri. With that schedule, can they finish better than 7-6? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. And also, which do you think was tougher, last season's non-conference schedule or this season's non-conference schedule? And which schedule in total was tougher last year's than this year's? I think this year's schedule is tougher because even though they played a home and home at BYU, BYU was a Group of Five technically last year, but I called them a Power Five independent. But I call them a Power 5 independent, but technically they're not. They weren't considered it officially. The only Power 5 independent officially was Notre Dame. I consider them not, but you can tell me if you think BYU is a Power 5 independent, then last season's probably would be tougher schedule then. But you let me know who you think was tougher for non-conference last year, as well as the entire schedule, last year's versus this year's. Let me know which is tougher. So again, thanks everybody for watching the video. If you haven't done it already, please hit the thumbs up, smash the like button. It helps with the algorithm, helps the video be seen by more people. Make the comments I said before, and subscribe to the channel. On the way to 4,000 subscribers, let's see if we can get there, folks. So thanks everybody for watching. Hope everybody's having a great day. The winds that were following me when I got into Georgia last evening, it's technically about 8:30. Well, they're starting to show up here now. Here we go again. So thanks everybody for watching. Be safe out there, and please be good to each other.